Hello and welcome back to XCOM2 War of the Chosen. My name is Syken. This is the Legendary Ironman Army of Two run, where we are beating the game on the highest difficulty with only two soldiers per mission. I've made my decision. I absolutely hate protect the device, but there's really not that much we can lose. Even if we were to lose India, we could regain it for 40 intel. It was the bonus here that allowed us to have contact cost half. So basically I'm just betting 40 intel versus potentially a colonel, which is worth 250 intel at this time in the game, or at this stage in the game. Protecting the device means we, however, need to be really, really fast. And thus, I will opt to go in with the fastest team that we do have, Renman and Syken. I know, it's a bit boring to see the same two soldiers over and over, and I'll promise to spice this up a little bit. We're going to invade another factory very soon, so we should have a bit more of variety. However, I really would enjoy having this additional Grenadier in our ranks, and yeah, that's why we're doing it. Other than that, for those of you who've just tuned in and haven't seen what has happened in the last couple of missions, we killed the second chosen. We're currently in the process of going for the third chosen, and I found out after fighting for the very first time against him that that's going to be a more difficult battle than anticipated originally, specifically since he's immune against any form of melee attack. That is really going to suck, because our probably best character at the moment, Hogbite, the Templar, would have little option of hurting him. Maybe two pistol shots per round and a couple of psionic attacks. But the question is that really going to work out against him? On the other hand, I was thinking, if we go with Renman here, we would have so much more firepower, right? I mean, we do have chain shot and rapid fire, both just dealing excellent damage. Anyways, before we get too far carried away, we need to protect our device, and oh my gosh, it is on the very other side of the map. I hate it when these things are happening, because it just makes it so difficult for us to actually get there. Maybe even lose the mission before we have a chance to get there. So let's take a short peek here. We need to really speed up our movement as far as possible. I would almost argue this here is that, yeah, if there's a pack here, this would be a bad position. This still is a position in cover. Okay, we could grapple hook over here and then take the route all the way to here. Probably the best scenario. Moving in without giving up our cover. Grappling. Increasing our movement speed by abusing the grappling hook. This here would be good, but it opens up this entire area, and I can almost guarantee you that there is going to be a pack somewhere around here. It's really a pretty open area, and there's even an entrance here, so moving all the way to here is not the best idea. Moving all the way to here also opens us up against Peck potentially on the other side. So as much as I want to go further, I think this here is the furthest that we should go, specifically since it's our last move. You can already see like how panicked I am to get to the device. Because depending on, yeah, that's the worst case scenario. I was about to say, depending on the pack right next to it, the device has about 60 hit points, And the gatekeeper deals 10 per shot.
Headed there now.
So that's a problem. By going to the door, I could almost guarantee that we're going to see someone. The only question that I'm having is how and where do we want to approach? I mean, over here, high ground definitely is a pretty valid option, but it would take a bit more time, right? So, thinking about moving here with run and gun, opening it up. That could really be an option.
Moving to fire position. On the move. Hostile forces.
Told you that there is going to be a pack. It's almost certain that that would be the case. We could use the Shredstorm cannon as a starter. Would pretty much injure every single one of them. Zirkim unfortunately would take too long to get over there. It's probably not, we can't just reach it in one turn. The other option would be rapid fire. Essentially killing one of them, but we're too far away, so probably it's probably going to be the Shredstorm cannon. Just because we're running out of time, I want to make sure that we are protecting the device to the best of our abilities. Okay, they should all move into our direction, more or less. Plus an Overwatch, but that's okay. I was expecting that to happen. Grenade is too far away. I mean, saturation fire could hit two of them, which is not the worst. We definitely should hand over one action to Renman. ...60% shot. Yeah, that could work. And that's even better. I'm wondering if we still have run and gun. I'm wondering if we still have run and gun active. This here definitely could work. Just to get closer. Trying to use all of the movement abilities that I have just to get closer to the target. Alright, he's almost down. This here should deal with both of the others. There we go. Both of the enemies are down. All right, triggered another pack, but that's okay. They should come into our direction. Currently, no one can see us. Well, maybe Maybe the Spectre can. But we can easily solve that problem. Just gonna move out of line of sight. We have untouchable, we have implacable, so both of... We should be fine. Those guys are moving in towards us. Bladestorm. Very nice hit. Alright, we're down to 40 hit points. Just out of curiosity. Okay, good. One more turn. One more turn and we're good to go. We could move up here. That wouldn't be enough. We can we could open this area here up. We can certainly improve our chances to hit. Frostbite isn't the worst choice there. Pretty certain we should go, we almost should go for an advanced teamwork here. Just out of curiosity, yeah, we can't really crit this guy. I wish we could go up here and take a shot against the Spectre. This is probably not a bad idea, just due to the amount of damage that we are dealing. Yeah, let's do that. It's more so setting up the enemies than anything else. Let's move over with an advanced teamwork because we don't need so much actions, but we need to kill these guys here. Frozen, by the way, reduces his defense or improves our chance to hit him. That is why that was one of many reasons why I did it originally. So let's soften him up a bit more. Good. Ready. So now we can go for Reaper and basically clean those guys up. Advanced hair trigger, good. I've got it. Moving up, I really want to get the Spectre next because the frozen Archon is not a threat. There we go. Might be able to kill it immediately with the first shot. If that is the case, we get death from above. If not, we can kill it at least. Yeah, 18 instead of 19. That's still okay. Could have been a crit for 19. Not a problem. The guy's frozen. We can kill it next turn. Down to 29 hit points. Is there any position where I could see him? Yep, there. So over here and here we would have positions where we could see him. So Zirkim can take care of this guy. can even grapple all the way over to here. Let me think. I really want to already try to go for the next pack. Question is, how do we want to pull it? The Codices and the Gatekeeper over there are a problem. We could go in and pull it, essentially moving back, killing the Archon, and therefore having an untouchable so that we couldn't be hit. That would be an option. Not sure, there's probably there was a second pack over here. Problem is, if we're triggering them and we don't do it right, they all might attack the device. Currently it's just the leader of the pack, the device takes some damage. It's a difficult situation in this run. Zirkim can move up here, essentially kill this guy, then grapple hook over here if need be. Or over here. We could also directly grapple hook over here. We still have a grenade. Could probably explode all of this here. Get some nice little line of sight. And take it from there. That's an option. Most certainly an option. But how do we want to deal with the guy downstairs? Fortunately, none of these spots here. He's just too close to, for us to see him. Yeah, shooting a rocket over here. Probably a pretty shooting a grenade over here is probably a pretty decent idea, just to get all of them. And if we are sending up here, we could take shots for the codices and kill them with one shot. Yeah, I'm almost convinced that that's the right way to go. We do have only two pieces of ammunition though, so we also need to reload at some point. Yeah, not sure. Like I said, it is more difficult than it may look. Let's take a peek and see if we pull another pack. I think we just pulled another pack. Now I am sure that we just pulled another pack. Like, it's no longer, I think it is. At that point, I know we have pulled another pack. Okay. We're dealing enough damage, that's fine. I'm just wondering if that's the right decision. Or if we want to escalate this here even further. Probably we won't. It's not a smart idea. No, I think we need to clean up a little bit and don't overdo it. Long thinking process, I'm sorry, but I really want to make sure that this is going to be successful. This here is going to kill. Give us death from above. Yeah, almost far enough. Almost. We could move up to here, slash him, and next turn we would kill him. Question is if we're triggering the other pack. We could alternatively move up here, which I think is not a bad idea. But up here we don't have run and gun, so scratch that plan. We could conceal ourselves, meaning both of them would need to move. They don't have a chance. However, that could also prompt that they will attack the device instead. We could cheese a little bit by attacking through the wall. High chance that we're triggering the other pack, by the way. But this guy would die next turn. Regardless, the wall would definitely crumble, so yeah, we would pull the other pack. And then finally, we could try to essentially kill this guy with a good old chain shot. Very insecure though. I think the most secure way of actually killing someone here is move into here. That would mean with our Bladestorm we're going to kill him, and that's pretty much it. Probably pulling the other pack, I'm aware of this. But this guy here will act first, before the others can, so we will kill him and get untouchable. I think we're just reloading at this point here. Could alternatively go to here and just offer a different target. Probably not the worst idea. Or we are swinging in and drop a grenade. Nah, I think we're just... Wait a second. One of them has a psionic bomb. So unless they drop it here, we might lose our ammunition next turn. So we could move over here. Could move over here and just trigger them to teleport back here and use the psionic bomb here. We can then pull ourselves out with the grappling hook, which would be helpful. That's the untouchable now. No, it's gateway. But gateway into untouchable, which is not bad. We can kill him next turn. Yeah, you can see that the device already has taken quite some damage. There we go, that's the Bladestorm. And the immediate kill. Alright, pretty good. So moving to here would mean we would see both of these guys, which is exactly what I want to do. So grappling hook. Into an elevated position. We could go for dual strike onto the gatekeeper. I think I'm just reloading at this stage. And what's my chance to hit the gatekeeper? It's 100%. Pretty solid. I think we can even hit him. Let's reload. And I think we can even hit him with the chain shot. Yeah, only 86%, so probably that's the right moment to start dual striking him. Yeah, let's go. Fortunately, not a crit.
Hard target, minimal damage.
Still good enough. We do not have Reaper yet. This here would kill him, but we would take damage. And alternatively, Oh, wait a second. I do have an idea.
I'm trusting you here.
Most important part is that we're killing the gatekeeper. And unfortunately, we're not ignoring his armor. So unless we are critting, one strike is not enough. But we might be able to just conceal ourselves. And is this increasing our crit chance? No, it isn't, because I haven't skilled it. My bad. It's still at 80% chance to immediately kill him. Good enough. Let's try that. All right, death from above. These two clowns are gone. We have untouchable and placeable. And we're going in. Just really solid 12 points of damage, plus killing the captain next turn. 13 points, I'm sorry. Psybomb. There we go.
Check it before you get too close.
Okay, so I guess the question of the day is, if I'm just going melee, we're looking for 12 to 13.
Okay, I'll go.
We're unaffected by Overwatch, by the way. No clue why exactly we can't see it whilst we're there, so might as well go here. Again, no clue why we cannot see it. All I can assume is that there is some sort of a visual bug and it's not really standing there. Nice one.
Still
Alright, good enough. So you can see, even though I like pressed on and we have absolute remarkable gear, plus it worked out quite well. So even with good tactics and a lot of pressure, this was still close. Make no mistake, the protection of the device had like what, 15% of its life left? You almost need to really sprint in, try to not pull too many enemies. You need additional actions in some shape or form, like a skirmisher. You need grappling hooks.
I can't imagine the aliens are too happy about this one, Commander. Hell of a job. Another impressive effort, Commander.
And we got ourselves a grenadier.
And yet you have exceeded them.
Why is it that this run is always giving us females with some sort of tobacco in their mouth? Bold females, that is, with some sort of tobacco in their mouth. Is that the XCOM perception of how a colonel is supposed to look like? We do have 24 ability points. Not going to customize her too much. Let's maybe say we're giving her one of these. Good. Sky Ranger pilot with goggles. And color coding her. There we go. As for personal combat sims, I think we have had a couple of them. Advanced conditioning, yes, good for her. And I guess we had another, I think here top shelf was another rescue, because all of our colonels should have at least some sort of a PCS implant. Good. Some assorted loot. Let's get that. And that's the end of the month. We are now getting 1,100 supplies. Immense resistance activity, almost no alien activity. Let's see what the last chosen is up to.
One of the chosen is getting closer to finding us, Commander.
All right, dark events. This here is bad. Sealed armor. We need to prevent that. Remove one block of avatar at the end of every month. Yes. And we got ourselves superior expanded magazines and advanced agility. That's good. More loot.
I'm getting closer every day.
Let's build the radio relay here real quick.
Quite the trail of destruction. At this rate, I'll be touring the Avenger in no time.
All right. We're almost done with our sergeant training. There we go. Ranger, and the next one is a grenadier, and then we're done.
Reading you loud and clear.
And there we go, even more supplies. We just got our training completed. Roby and Hawkbite are done with their training, which is a good moment in time to visit the training center, generally speaking. Let's take a look at Roby. We got a lot of XCOM APs left over. We already mentioned that we want to have rapid fire. If we were to buy the last slot here, that'll be 20 additional AP. And we could use it for either cereal, which is not too bad, or for a chain shot, which I think is also worthwhile, or personal favorite, rupture. Specifically against harder hitting enemies, I figure that is worth it. Or I think he already has untouchable. Yeah, he already has untouchable. So yeah, it's the question, one more more additional multi-hitting skills, or are we going for that rupture? I think rupture is really good. Highly underutilized, and in the combination with Hawkbite is probably the better choice. Rupture plus amplified attack, like that would be a lot of damage. We're looking at plus 5 for every single hit. Ever vigilant, super good, could use that. Covering fire also not bad. Those aren't bad either, like combat protocol, I can see usage of this. As for Hawkbite, I think we're pretty much done. I mean, face-off is an option, definitely. But what would we want to give up? Probably nothing. Yeah, I think we're done with him. And since I don't want to use the points on anything other than my main characters here, we're going to go for freeing up of the last slot. Which means not really lightning reflexes, but oh shit, did I really? Okay, I just wasted 2 AP. My bad. What I meant to take was rupture. Another 25 points, so we're looking at 21. And everything after we get rupture is kind of a bonus. I think covering fire would be probably the next ability afterwards. But yeah, these abilities here are grandiose. I really like it. Do we have anyone else with extra points left over? No, not so much. We just got her, so probably rupture for her would be a good option. Might as well take it. And 9 points. I don't want to use other XCOM points. Although, of course, volatile mix isn't bad. Implacable is also not bad. Death from above certainly would be a good ability for her. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Good. So, since our main team is finally available, might as well have some fun with them, shall we? How about we're doing a bit of an excavation? How about we are going for one of these facilities? So If we were to take this one here, we would get mutants and a gatekeeper. I don't want to fight mutants. In here, officers, purifier, trooper, gatekeeper, sectopod, shield bearer, andromedon. Ah, mutants again. What is it with these pesky mutants? What is it down here? Spectre, gatekeeper, trooper, purifier, shield bearer, priest. Perfect. That is exactly the sort of mission that I think we should undertake. Setting course for the officer. Let's cleanse the earth from all of the facilities and get it over with. We're going to do that next mission though. And I can already forecast it's going to be Hogbite and Roby, but I need to equip them correctly. So whilst we are staring at the two of them, I wanted to thank you for taking the time and tuning in. If you enjoyed what you've seen, give it a like and leave a comment. Or if you haven't done so, subscribe to the channel. As always, have a great day and see you in a couple of days when we are continuing this run. Bye-bye.